There is no truth superior to me. Everything rests upon me as pearls are strung on a thread.
Okay, yeah, well, that quote basically was talking about was basically that it says, there is no truth superior to me. That me is talking about your soul or God, right? Your higher self. It says, everything rests upon me, that same soul, as pearls are strung on a thread. Now, that's basically what we're going to be dealing with today, is this quote. And this is out of the Bhagavad Gita chapter, I believe, chapter 7, verse 7. And the title, basically, we're going to be dealing with the topic. And this is basically an analogy, basically, a metaphor of spiritual awakening or enlightenment. It's called the necklace of pearls. And basically, in the mythology of the East, in Buddhism, Hinduism, Taoism, Jainism, Sikhism, so on, they have a concept of the divine pearl and the divine pearl necklace or garland of pearls. And Lakshmi is known to wear the pearl necklace. Vishnu, Krishna, a lot of the forms of Shakti like Durga, even Saraswati wears the divine pearls. So if the divine feminine or the divine masculine wears the pearl necklace, it'll be related to this info I'm about to go into. So I'm gonna go ahead and start it out with breaking it down. But basically, the pearl itself represents a liberated soul. So what's the origin of a pearl? Where do pearls come from? Well, we know that they come from clams, right? Deep in the bottom of the ocean. Well, the clam itself is nothing but your ego, the clam, right? You know, just think about it. It's deep under the ocean, in the ocean of samsara. And samsara basically means this physical world, this world of suffering, this world of bondage, this world of illusion. So that's basically samsara. It's the wheel of reincarnation, death, rebirth, and reincarnation, which all the spiritual masters, no matter what background they come from, whether it's Africa, Asia, or Europe, or ancient Europe, or southern Europe, no matter where they come from, all of these spiritual masters are trying to get liberated from death, rebirth, and reincarnation. And this is not talking about reincarnating in animals. This is talking about lineal or ancestral reincarnation. The goal is basically to get liberated from this physical world by not being reborn, and not being an ancestral deity reborn here. So that's samsara. Samsara is this wheel. But the ocean is nothing but a metaphor of samsara, because the ocean is what vast, you know what I'm saying? It's the biggest thing that we can comprehend right here on the earth. Well, samsara is basically a metaphor for it being just as vast, and it's deep and it's dangerous, right? And the danger comes from these marine animals, right? These predator marine animals that are in the sea. Now, we know we got octopus, sharks, killer whales, crabs, you know, all different types of animals. Some of them poisonous, some of them will sting you. And basically, all of those animals are a metaphor for the different mundane principles or the worldly principles, which basically you might translate as demons. But they keep you, these animals keep you from being able to collect these shells, to collect these clam shells. It keeps you from being able to collect these pearls that are inside the clam shell. But basically, the clam, like I said, is the ego. The clam shell is nothing but your physical body. So you gotta break it open and get the pearl out, which is your soul. You collect them where? In samsara. That's where all of these pearls are. Remember, Lakshmi or Vishnu wears the pearl necklace as a image of what beauty and divine, what enlightenment or divine transcendental states. So that's what the pearl necklace represents on the divinity or on the divine figure, the divine deity. So basically what I'm showing basically is your goal, our goal in life is only to collect these pearls or collect your pearl and put them on the necklace or the garland of the divine. So with that being said, the goal is basically, we're dealing with the metaphor, is to get these pearls, which are these souls. You got to live your life and understand that everybody that you see is really a potential clamshell that you have to mentally understand is a pearl within them. And that pearl is eventually going to be collected and put on the necklace of pearls of God. So you have to understand that. They may be in the dirt, in the murk, and in the gutter of the ocean of samsara, this world. They may be suffering, they may be evil, they may be what you call good people, whatever. It's a diversity of type of lifestyles we live as humans. But whoever you see, remember, they are one of the pearls. They contain one of the pearls on the necklace of God, period. So your goal should be to consciously, daily, collect these pearls and put them back on the necklace, or give or offer that necklace to God. I won't even say back, but put that those pearls together on a necklace and offer it to God. And your God is nothing but your soul, your own higher self within your body, right? So let's help you understand that it's not literal. We're saying mentally do this. This is a spiritual practice.
Right.
So if you can recognize everybody in this ocean of samsara as clamshells, as nothing but clams, then you can see the pearl and begin to collect and put together this necklace. So it starts off as a piece of sand. It ends up for a long period of time in the ocean inside of the clam, and the clam begins to take that soul and make it become what? Enlightened. Enlightened basically is when the speck of sand becomes a pearl. It represents your soul becoming what? Enlightened. Once you're enlightened, there's two different types of being enlightened. But remember, the pearl represents the liberated soul or the enlightened soul. The pearl necklace that is on Lakshmi represents you awakening, having your liberation while you're alive, while you're in this physical world. So that's possible, to be able to recognize this deep knowledge while you're alive. And remember, Lakshmi represents Maya or Boo or the physical world. Her name is Boo Devi, Boo Devi. These are many of her names. But basically, this represents the physical world, the dense realm of matter, of mother matter. So material, maternal, same thing. So Lakshmi is the whole material world. So if you put the pearl necklace on her, what you're doing is you're recognizing God while you're alive, while you're living your day-to-day life as a human. But if you're attempting to put the pearl necklace on Vishnu, you're actually putting it on the spiritual world, and that would be when you close your eyes, not the external world. Lakshmi is when you open your eyes in this world we see. But when you close your eyes, you're going into the realm of Narayan, or Vasudeva, Vishwaroop, and basically that's Vishnu. And that spiritual world pervades all throughout the physical world, just like a relationship between the two. They're always married or interconnected. But when you close your eyes, that realm of consciousness is called the Sea of Narayan, which is nothing but Nara means water or consciousness. So that realm within is Vishnu. So you can put that pearl necklace on Vishnu, and that happens for people when they get liberated after they die. But you have to get consciousness, you have to get enlightenment while you're alive for both. But you can be liberated while you're alive in this physical world. But you have to put the pearl necklace on the concept or on the reality, which is the deity or the allegorical figure. But basically the reason why we can't see the pearl necklace from day to day and offer it to God is because we haven't gotten to the reality that there's a thread. Now that thread that's in the pearl necklace, you have to put the pearls together. But what is the thread? The thread is nothing but the spirit. Now when I say spirit, in the Hebrew system, that's the Ruach, has many names, Yakita, the Neshama, as many words in the Hebrew, the Christian world, the Holy Spirit and so on. But in the East, amongst the Dravidians and Tamilians in India, they would say it's prana. So you have to understand prana, and prana is basically small pieces, small particles of the bigger sea of Brahman or God. So you have to realize that the spirit or the breath, the prana, is what connects us all. It's all one. We're all the same being. But that thread itself that connects us all is Krishna or God within inside of every single being, God within in all beings. So you have to realize that by realizing this metaphor of the pearl necklace. You see, you have to be able to gather the pearls out of the deep ocean of samsara, break them out of the clams, which are these egos, these human bodies, these egos. Avoid the predatory marine animals that, like sharks, that will basically keep you from getting these pearls. And the shark could be pride, ego, lust, greed, materialism. These are all of the different mundane principles or worldly concepts, worldly consciousness, worldly ideas that keep you from getting the pearls. And so you can have the necklace and the pearls and just be living your life, and you understand this because you might leave with this understanding, this concept. But you have to understand, once you connect them, connect the necklace, for the deities to put the necklace on, they have to what? Connect it. And that connection represents the realization of God. It's called Nirvana, Mukti, Moksha, many names. But it basically represents you being in total consciousness of your own true self, your higher self, which is beyond the clamshell. You realize that you're the pearl on the necklace of God, and we all are. And that's your true self, not who you were born as, not who your mother sold together in the womb, not your flesh, not your race, not your gender, not your age, none of that. All of that is temporary and it's an illusion. Eventually you'll die, this body will decay. So what are you really? You're a pearl that needs to be collected and put on the necklace of God. And with that, hopefully y'all understand. I'll be breaking it down even more thoroughly, these concepts, in the future, but you have to get that connection. Once you get the pearl necklace, connect it. And this is your daily meditation, this is your daily effort. Connect these pearls in the ocean of samsara. Everybody that you see in your life, your family, your friends, society as a whole, people you work with, remember, all of them are these clamshells. And it's going to be hard to break the ego, but you're not trying to break them, you're trying to break your idea of them in your own mind. You look at them as nothing but humans and people in a hard shell trapped in the bottom of this material world, just the physical human. But really, their potential is that sand that's within them shall become a pearl and return or be offered to the neck of God.